I think first of the things we have to start with is analytical thinking. I think it's very important for IT pupils to be able to analyze a complex problem and to divide it into manageable chunks and to work on these things. Another thing I think is really important is independence, being able to independently work on solutions. And more specific on solving problems. So not with the first problem you encounter already, call one of your colleagues or call a teacher in a school setting, but being able to work independently on it. And the third thing I think is perseverance. Tackling these problems is sometimes very hard and sometimes also takes a lot of time. So it's really important also that you persist in it and that you keep working on it until you have a solution for your problem. Well, if I look at ICT, I think one of the things is being a team player. If you look at IT companies later on, people will always work in teams, so it's very important for them to be a team player. Linked to that, I also think that communication is very important for IT personnel, being able to communicate with your colleagues, with end users, with management, and so on, very important. And next, also linked to that, I think, is languages. English is very important as a language in ICT because most of the information you find online about computing is always in English. Also, if you work together in multinational teams, English is mostly the language used in that team. And then more specifically here in Flanders, I also think that knowledge of French is also very important. Become a lifelong learner. That's important for everyone, but especially in the ICT sector, where everything changes very rapidly, it's very important that you, first of all, love to learn new things, and second of all, also are able to learn yourself new things. Because it's not the case that you always go on trainings, you also have to learn a lot just on yourself. I think it will be the analytical thinking, so having that complex problem, being able to split it up in smaller sub-problems, being able to solve these problems and to combine these solutions together to fix the larger problem at hand. And I think you can already start learning this from a very young age, even without ICT. Example that I use, we don't make it ourselves, is baking an egg. So get the pan, get an egg, break an egg, put it in the pan. I already forgot the butter, so.
I'd say it's important not to focus necessarily on the kind of outcome in terms of their levels. I think the skills you need to like really home in on is like see that they've progressed in their interaction with other students, see that they've actually not gone straight away to, sir, can you help me with this? They've actually took the time saying, look, I've got this problem, and they're thinking about it. Also, the computational thinking does lend itself in there, but that they've actually got the kind of skills to understand which tool applies to and when they should use that. I think that's really important for them.
I think now the development is more collaboration. So the fact that you can work in a team, talk, share ideas, that's coming out very strongly in all curriculums at the moment. So we're doing a lot of development on teaching thinking. So sometimes it's not that the students don't actually learn it, it's getting them to express their teaching and using the right language to tell you that they have actually got that sort of understanding. So sometimes they can do it, but when you ask them to tell you how they did it, they haven't got the language skills to do that. So
a lot of it's really the creative design, and not forgetting about the nitty-gritty and the technical part of it, but having an understanding of what you want to achieve, and having maybe using mind maps and in the form of algorithms, but getting away from the nitty-gritty syntax. Understanding, here's what I want this piece of software to do, this piece of hardware to do, and understanding it, and then getting all of that, the hard skills to get it to perform. So really visualizing the end product, visualizing how it's going to do it, and not getting caught up with the technicalities of the syntax. or the environment.